It's Wednesday at 7 p.m. Central. That means it's time for the Axe and Arcana fantasy adventure game on the internet broadcast system. Hey everybody, how's it going? How's everybody feeling?
Time is a meaningless construct.
Let's see. I get the feeling that we are... Is Dago here?
Hello?
Oh, yeah. Let me turn your volume up. Get everybody's volumes fixed. Cool. All right. How's everybody doing?
Good, good, good. Ready to do it.
Cool. All right. So
excited to resume our adventures.
Yeah. Let's do a quick recap. You adventurers witnessed your wizard friend Barris Grelmdar get kidnapped by the Mind Flayer host Frang. You pursued your kidnapped patron in his airship, the Aerial Range Consciousness, aka Ark. You guys took to the skies and then to the astral seas in pursuit of your friend. A couple hijinks later, you found your ship detonated and exploded. And the next thing you knew, you woke up on the shores of an island. You don't know where. You found each other. And through some smarts and goodwills, you were able to get some assistance from a local Sahaguin tribe. And they located the missing scraps of Ark using the holy might of Bado, the Loxodon cleric, the technical skills of ID10T, the Warforged wizard, and the hammering strength of Zothok, the half-orc barbarian. You are able to reassemble Ark into nothing spacefaring or not even skyfaring, but something that is buoyant. And the Sahaguin, at the end of our last adventure, said they would help point you in the direction of coasts where you could find more help. And you guys worked through the next couple weeks. You've taken a long rest. All of your skills and spells are top notch. And the adventure starts as you guys wake up to prepare to get into Ark and sail off towards the mainlands. So what would you find yourself doing on this nice, it's kind of muggy morning. Sun's just coming up, maybe 7 in the morning, just over that horizon. But it's already a warm day. There's kind of a lack of a breeze on this day. And how do you find yourself preparing for your trip ahead?
You said there's a lack of a breeze. I assume we're stuck with wind power. Versus whatever was power the future science that was powering Ark before.
When ID10T plugs itself into the console, you guys can get a little charge to propel your ship. It's not going to be anything outstanding, but there will be no point really outside of maybe when he's resting that you couldn't move if there was no wind. But we're talking like maybe 5 knots, you know. But there, the sails were up. There's a slight breeze. I guess I was using it more as a descriptor to sort of... It's just like the weight of the hot tropical sun doesn't feel like it's really moving. But winds shift on a dime all the time, as you've noticed. Your ears maybe swaying to the east, and then in a moment's notice, they start blowing towards the west. You know it's going to be a 4-day sail, jaunt across the water. So using that as a gauge of what to prepare for, what do you find yourself doing?
I'm gathering coconuts.
Yeah, double checking all of our provisions and, you know, pulling on ropes, making sure they're sturdy, all that good stuff.
The ship.
Double checking. Triple checking.
The ship seems sailable. It seems like it'll do its job. As far as consumables go, you guys have. You do not necessarily have stacks of stuff like you did previously in Ark, but you've been able to pull stuff from the ocean. So you guys have had one or two more of those giant crabs since then. So you've got a day or two's worth of seafood provisions with you at the moment. Zothox grabbing some coconuts.
Water.
Coconut water.
Do either of you have purify water, make water, maybe the wizard? Do you have anything like that? ID10T? Turn your volume up here, bud. And then also,
my God has not seen fit to bestow such a. No, wait, maybe.
I see no need to purify water or create food.
Yeah, I can destroy water or create.
Yep, that's it. You can create water.
Yes.
Okay. So you do not find yourself at thirst.
Great.
Yeah.
With that, I think I'm ready to try to get on the ship. Heave-ho.
Zothok loads up his goods. Who did we decide who is wearing the grass skirt?
Identity, no. Surely.
No, I've got the Hawaiian hat. Shirt on.
You can have both.
Zothok.
I can't be the only one.
Zothok throws his goods onto the boat and is eager to get out. I sense maybe some uncomfortableness from seeing horizon everywhere instead of treetops and mountains.
Also sand and crack.
Sand and crack.
So much sand.
It's coarse and it gets in everywhere.
Don't worry, if we get lost, we'll just pull over and ask for directions.
So Zothak, on the boat. Who's next on the boat? Any last business before you guys set sail?
I'll gather my things in a little square cloth and tie it to a stick.
As you
hop up on the junk heap.
As you wrap up your bundle, Cat, the intellect devourer that has come sentient while in your control, hops out from around a corner. You see a it was feasting on something. You see feet sticking out from behind a rock. ID10T, fish-like feet. Sticking out from behind a rock where Cat, the intellect devourer, comes around after hearing you gather your things.
All right. I'm going to go ahead and continue on towards the boat.
All right. So ID10T and Cat, the intellect devourer, mosey on up onto that ship. Bado, anything before you step aboard?
Just a quiet, solemn moment of thoughtful reflection on that fact that we survived this far and that I never have to see this godforsaken rock again.
Oh, how do you really feel about it? All right, so you guys get aboard the, I don't want to say shoddily repaired, but it's not at its peak shape. There's a couple of Sahagwin and the priest, Zatara, that you guys helped out there to see you off. They're kind of waving to you as you get on the ship, making gestures alien aquatic gestures to signify their respect and thanks to you.
I dab.
They cringe. Thank you, friends. They're addressing ID Tenti because they had some sort of reverence for him.
They
were trying to pronounce your name, but they don't have tongues, or so they kind of click through their gills, and they point you in the direction to head towards the lands with the prismatic mountain, to help you seek whatever answers. He knows you guys were talking about falling through something or another, but everything above the surface of the water is kind of the same to him, to be honest. So points you in the direction for your help, and him and his crew start to swim out to the water again, and they kind of wait chest deep for you to sail off.
Wait.
Yes.
As a gift of thanks, and I will open up my little cloth bag, and I will pick up one of the little dead brain rats that I picked up from a few sessions ago, and I'll hand it to him.
He
please
reaches out of the water.
Thank you.
And grabs
my hands. You can't see, but my hand is making gestures. Thank you.
See, we gotta get on cameras, gang. It's unsure how to react to it, but it doesn't want to seem rude, so it grabs the dead cranium rat by the tail, and you see it kind of look at his friend and shrug, like, I don't know.
Yeah, bunch of weirdos.
Yeah.
It's rotten by now.
The brain and the eyes are really... The brain and the eyes, they're like a translucent white, the way they were, but everything else has seemed to decompose, to mat down and eat away. But you hand the pickled cranium rat to it, and he hands it over to one of his compatriots, and you see him kind of wipe his fingers off in the water. He's like, thank you and good luck on your journey. And they await your exit.
Well,
get in the power socket.
Yeah, ID Denti, it's up to you to.
You must kickstart.
I'm gonna hop on board. So maybe it'll get us to land. I'm sure of it.
Let's
pop into that socket.
Shouldn't we crack flex. Coconut on front?
And flex.
Flex as a robot should.
All right, let's take this away. All right, so the ship starts to surge. ID Denti dips in power a little bit as Arcana is drawn from his systems and starts to flow through the veins of the ship, and it slowly starts to chug forward. Zothok is kind of playing with some ropes, and one of the piece of canvas catches wind, and the ship starts to gain some more speed, and the island you've spent some time on starts to fade into the distance behind you.
I
continue to wave.
As the island reaches the horizon, I say, I thought I should mention.
No, what?
I think Cat might have eaten one of them. Did not see it as pertinent to bring up in front of them.
Just one pretty good number.
I'm aside, like, just disbelief. Like, you let this happen?
No, I saw it a little while after the fact. But, you know, no use crying over spilt milk.
Cool. So
yes, very.
The ship sinks back into the distance on the horizon line. You navigate through a small chain of islands that sort of dotted the perimeter of this place. And before you is not but open ocean.
Those seas, they be a churning.
They are churning real good.
Well, I tried to, so I found this is actually half of a video that I had to mirror, put next to each other, rotate, and then I tried to slow the speed down, but cool. I had like 10 minutes
like
to jump on.
It's like a speedboat.
It's a really big ocean. You're going really fast, but the ocean's like really big.
Nice, dude.
So, the day starts to draw on. The heat from the sun starts to wear on you as you realize the only shade out here is from the occasional passover by the sails.
Have a lower deck?
You do have a lower deck, yes.
Ah, but yes, we're up on top.
Yes. When you notice it gets too hot, I imagine the old man, Bado. Oof.
You've got this handled.
How do you
see? I have faith.
How do you see yourself passing the time on the ship?
May I ask a question?
Yes.
What is Cat doing?
Cat's kind of up on the aft of the ship, kind of taking in all of the scents of the brains beneath the surface of the water.
Okay. Does it still have my hat?
Yes, you put your hat on it. It slides off from time to time.
Right.
A great way to pass the time would be to see if the brain will play fetch.
What do you want to play fetch with?
Coconut.
All right. So Bado takes a coconut out. Do you just hear boy? What do you?
Yeah. And I roll it, not throw it. Get the coconut.
Is there like handle animal checks in this version?
Yeah,
make me that. Por favor.
I like to imagine that the steering wheel that we have, I'm like, literally, it's got like 45 degrees of like room to wiggle, and so I'm literally just like moving this thing like back and forth, like, you know, like 60 degrees as we're moving straight.
It's perfect. We
rebuilt
it perfect.
I rolled a natural 20 for handle animal.
Oh, you would.
He's so mad.
Plus 3. Handle it so good.
So you roll the coconut, and it catches the interest of the intellect devourer. It kind of hops over to it, and you see it. It does that playful dog thing where it lowers down its hind legs, sticks up its rear legs, and you see it kind of quiver and start to glow.
Uh-oh. Identity, has it done that before?
Oh, I have no idea.
And it looks frustrated. It keeps doing that and nothing happens, and it'll shimmy over a couple feet to the other side and do it again. And after the third failed try of whatever Cat is doing, it kind of gives up and goes back to doing what it was doing.
Aww. I rolled to see if I'm feeling queasy. I am feeling queasy.
Oh, you feeling nauseous there, bud? Wizard. Oh, because you've never been on a ship, huh? Ooh, that's interesting. Wait, one second.
Oh.
see, good call, bud. All right. Not queasy. Let us say you are... We're going to put you in the same category as poisoned. The sea has poisoned you. Your land legs aren't used to the water. Good call. Hey, why don't you take one of them there, inspiration die.
Heck yeah.
No, so anybody who's not used to 5th edition D&D, an inspiration die is a free d20. At any point, Zothok the Barbarian rolls a d20. If he does not like that roll, he can take that initiative, that inspiration die, and roll it, and he gets to take the higher of the two rolls. Alternately, he can gift it to somebody else. You find yourself Zothok, this mighty half-orc barbarian from the primitive era, has been bested by the ship, and you toss lunch over the side. That crab was real good going down, not as much coming up. And then all the coconut water you've been pounding. It was real watery.
Diarrhea and puke.
Do I notice this?
No, you're down. Wait. Roll me a d4.
Three.
Make me a perception check.
Perception. Is it smell based?
Yeah, it is smell based.
Gross. But not wrong.
That's the thing for 20. Me, man. When I So
but not natural. 17 plus.
Your Loxodon trunk picks up that acrid whiff of stomach contents as it drifts downstairs into Ark. But you didn't need to smell it to feel the drip of it through some of the boards as it's kind of like piddling down onto an empty corner in the bottom of the ship, because the first two times he threw up, he made it to the side of the ship. But that third time, he didn't make it. So there's a little
disgusting
puke down here.
Gross. I'll go up and investigate. Hey, Zothok. You okay, buddy?
What is wrong with Zothok?
You say rocking the wheel left and right?
Clash.
The trick is to hit the waves and go higher.
I don't think Zothok's had the... pleasure of the open seas before.
Is not pleasure.
He made it over the edge that time.
I think I can help with this. Nothing else has happened today. I'll go ahead and waste a. It's not a waste. He's a friend.
Yeah. Oh, that's perfect.
I want him to feel good so that he can, you know, kick ass. All right. Yes, lesser restoration.
Lesser restoration, I dig it. We're not going to worry about the technicals of it. You call to your Loxodon cleric. Who's your god, by the way? Did we ever?
No, I need to fill that. All right.
You pray to your higher power, whatever it is. We don't judge here. And... this graceful light comes down, and Zothok, you feel like you just drank a ginger ale. There's bubbly in your stomach. Your legs start to regain their strength. And while that liquid in your ears is still kind of swashing around and you're a little uncomfortable, you don't feel the need to be sick no more.
Oh, thank you.
But... that hunger from emptying the contents of your stomach has suddenly kicked in, right? As you are no longer worried about being queasy, you're like, oh, I'm hungry again.
I sense a cycle.
Is
coconut around. We have coconut.
So Zothak cracks open a coconut and partakes in its sweet flesh. How is navigating ARC going, ID10T?
Splendid.
Will you make me a check? Like a navigation check?
Our path is the representative of a spline wave.
Serpentine. Yeah, will you make me a... would it be a survival check? I need a character sheet in front of me.
Let me go ahead and just roll.
Yeah, roll me. Let's see what you get.
15, but depending on the skill.
I'm 15's good. 15's pretty solid. You feel pretty confident. There was a little drift, but you kind of shook up and re-steered the front of your ship a little bit using the sun as a guide to make sure your aim is continually true. Let's see. Zothak, make me a perception check.
Fourteen.
Alrighty. You were looking around for a coconut, you find one, you kind of crack one open. Let's see. Where do you see yourself spending most of your time on the ship?
Up on top as much as I can to see the horizon.
Up in front, in the middle, up back by ID10T.
Wherever the shade is, I will move with the shade.
All right, so you're kind of kicking it in here. You notice, while you're kind of sitting here and you're munching on your coconut, you notice a off sort of port up and to the left of your ship. You notice a circle of birds, right? Like there's something off in the distance and you see birds circling.
I will relay that message to ID50.
Who saw it?
Zothak saw it while he was kind of munching on his coconut.
Okay.
You below deck.
Do I see it?
You are below deck. I mean, Zothak, if you see yourself, like, yelling this...
Yeah, we'll yell it to
ID10T. So, yeah, we'll say below deck, Bado heard that.
What?
Oh boy, something to do.
What bird. Did you say?
Bird circle.
Yes, pretty birds.
No, they, something in water. Go.
Whoa,
go to birds.
Okay. Turning.
I'm just gonna... spin the wheel as hard as I can towards the birds.
Zothak feels the urge to toss lunch again, but the might of the Loxodon's god is kind of keeping his trap shut.
I should hope so.
God of Pepto-Bis.
So you take maybe 40-45 minutes to veer towards the circling birds. As you get closer, you realize there's some sort of scavengers of some sort.
Go ahead and slow down, if we can.
Yeah, here.
Nope, can't slow down.
Right by.
Did I give us a... I thought I downloaded a backup water texture.
Oh, you don't have to worry about that.
I was just making sure that the ship was slowing down.
Yeah, ship starts to slow down. As you see parts of ship wreckage sort of scattered about, the first thing that floats towards you is a barrel from the wreckage. It sort of taps the front of the hull of Ark and starts to roll around the left side of the ship.
Question.
Yes, sir.
What is the water integrity of the ship? The watertight integrity?
Now you ask.
In what manner? Why do you...
I'm going to go ahead and set her down a little bit into the water right next to the ship.
You're doing what?
So the ship has been in the water the whole time.
Yeah.
I thought we were flying over it.
No, you've been... in the water. Yeah, the ship does not have air capabilities. Sorry, bud.
All right. Well, that's why I was like, heck yeah. But, okay.
Yeah.
We were like, why are you asking now?
Like, I feel like in ID10T's mind, he thought he was like soaring 40 feet above the water on the ship, like it was normal. And you guys are watching it go like 2 knots in the water. Feel the wind in your hair.
that does make a lot of sense.
You don't even have hair.
I have strands of fibers in my grass skirt. Then I'll slow down and come to a stop next to the
see if I can grab that
wreckage.
Barrel.
The Loxodon reaches over and the barrel is, it's like a water barrel. You're able to, how you getting it?
That's why I'm looking. I actually don't have any.
There's some rope on the ship you find if you need some. You can have a little rope as a treat.
Not that rope. That rope is holding the ship together.
Nah, I got rope.
That's our bit, and he didn't even know it. Not that rope. Yeah, there's spare rope if you need some, Bado.
I got some from when we climbed down the side of the cliff.
So you throw your rope over, and you're able to...
I'll make a lasso first, you know.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Make a ranged touch attack to try to lasso the barrel.
That's just dex, right?
Yeah.
Plus dex?
Yeah.
We're fully stopped now.
Aww.
Yeah, the ship's about stopped. Yeah.
10.
10. Mm-hmm. 10's enough to hit it. It wasn't moving too fast. It's a pretty... easy source, and you know, being a former soldier, I imagine you used rope
sometime in your life.
At some point, yeah. So you're able to lasso over and draw the barrel up onto the deck of Ark, the ship. Let me see if I got a barrel to open.
I feel like now's a good time to mention that I'm gonna. Well, how does heavy armor work with swimming?
You are at disadvantage for swimming.
But not for other athletics checks.
It depends on the check. So, like, stealth checks, you are...
Yeah, that has the disadvantage marker next to it.
I'm going to unhook from the slot, roll on over to the side.
All right.
Take a look down. What's it look like? What's the wreckage look like? Do a little... ocular pat down on the wreckage.
Everybody who's investigating the wreckage, make me a perception check.
Okay, that's a big oof. Oof. I got a 7.
21.
Alright, so...
perceive the shit out of that thing.
ID10T, you see Bado lifting that barrel, doing a real good job. What's up, Ark Reactor?
You're doing a real good job.
As
good solid hooping.
As
nice nodding.
you're pulling it up. Bado and Zothok are kind of surveying the rest of the wreckage. And who rolled higher? Who rolled a 21?
Me.
Bado.
Am I pulling it up?
No, you're watching him pull it up.
Okay.
You looked over and rolled an 8. So your gaze got transfixed on the first moving object, and boy, it was that barrel.
It's a nice barrel. I wonder what's inside.
Zothok, you see a guy sort of floating on some driftwood, and the ocean's loud, and you can see him waving like to get your attention. But it's Bado's 21 perceptions that sees the giant fin behind him. And then you, all three of you, no longer see the guy hanging onto the board.
Ooh.
Is bad.
Is bad.
Hurry up with that barrel, will you?
Is there anyone else in the water? Obviously, there might be a few more stragglers.
I squint. I look around. I rolled a 21 to see if there
are any. Am I noticing did I notice the guy going?
Your eye looked up as there was like a quick whip of movement as he went down. So you're not sure what you saw, but you did see something. Bado rolled another perception as he squinted in to see. ID10T, if you would like to make another perception check to look over in that area, you can.
All right. That time I got a 20.
Excellent. 19 plus 1. Bado, would you like to make another look out there, or is there something else you would rather do?
Nope. Now that I know that they're possible survivors, I'm going to smell them out.
Roll me that perception check.
The better of the two was 12.
So Bado searches around and that trunk whiffs at the air. It picks up little bits of salt.
Mostly salt.
So like from the scent, you notice from your time in the army, you're not picking up any burning scents. There's no like gunpowder in the air.
But
you don't see any other survivors.
Do I smell blood and carnage?
Ooh. That's a 12 to smell blood in the air. You see there's a dark spot in the water where the survivor was.
Ooh.
But you don't necessarily pick up the smell of guts. So it's the other two with their roll. Notice the shape moving just outside of your ship. And a circling motion.
Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go.
How big?
How big what? Is the circle?
Is this...
Is the thing that we're...
Shadow.
You're kind of like trying to get a bead on it. Give me a second.
I did mention that I don't have my armor on.
That's fine.
It won't make a difference.
So you're sort of looking out. Dave, did you guys know it's Shark Week?
I did. Thanks to Spotify.
So you look out and you see this big old fin raise out of the water. Just outside of your ship, and it's like a 6-foot fin. Ugh. And it...
My eyes widen.
Oh, let's put Bado.
6-foot fin. Ugh.
Yeah, so that's a
big fish.
Maybe fish.
That? You see this ancient looking creature of the depths come up occasionally and then dip back down below the surface. Ooh, I'll keep it here.
I'm going to roll to recall from all of my extensive knowledge that I don't remember anything that might even be related to this gigantic
you
want to
do like a knowledge animals?
Yeah, like yeah. Knowledge. Yeah. Okay, 14. And let's just go with a plus one, so 15.
So you, I imagine ID10T's stock sort of stiffens up as this scan of your database rolls through, and it's like dee 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 with the images and drawings of different anatomy and organs, and then it just lands on shark, comma big,
not dog, not cat.
Yeah, that's because yeah, maybe your binary system, is it a cat?
Okay.
No. Okay. Not next, cat. Is it a dog? Oh, no. It's a not cat, not dog, shark big. and it seems to be in a pattern fixated on your ship that is now sitting still.
We should go.
We should not be sitting still anymore. Yeah, I'd say let's try and move away from this thing. Go back easterly. Quickly now. Chop chop.
Okay.
if you would.
19, 18, whistle as I go back to the slot and hook back in.
Well, as you go back to the slot.
Oh no.
You start rolling back into the steering cabins of the Ark. The other two party members on the outside notice the fin dip under. Sort of as you're rolling back. Mm. And it's quiet for a second.
Oh, no.
And then the ship rocks to the left as the giant shark makes an attack on your ship. Let's pull up
this
ship.
Are we rolling for initiative?
I'm going to roll this attack first, and then, yes, we will roll initiative.
Oh, all right. Am I going to get into the thing or?
Yeah, it's sort of like cinematically as you were getting in there, like you go to put it on and it sort of like rocks you over before you're able to. So the giant shark comes up, makes an attack and bites into the hull of the Ark.
Oh, boy.
Gone under the ship.
All right, so the giant shark bites and takes 17 points. Well, it bites for 17, and you hear the wood creak and moan as the powerful mandibles, aka the jaws, of this creature bite down on the ship, and it does a little bit of damage. The ship rocks and pushes over. Not pushes over, but, you know, sort of tips for a second. And now we can roll for initiative.
I have a very serious question.
I believe it.
That just came across ID10T's mind the second that happened.
What's How that? Many hit points does the ship have?
No. Am I buoyant?
I am.
Let's not find out.
It's a good question. It's a good question. Depends on what the moment looks like, huh?
All right.
So let's roll initiatives.
Okay.
What did everybody get?
I got a 15.
Okay. Zothak or Bado?
11 for Bado.
No, you almost did it. And Zothak.
Six.
Zothak got a six, and I got 16. So it's gonna be the shark, followed by ID Tenti, followed by Bado with Zothak in the rear. All right. So you notice it hit the back of the ship where there was puke sort of coating the the side. It goes underwater. And you feel the ship rock again. But it's not a super solid. You feel a bump from beneath this time as opposed to on the side. And you sort of feel the boat lift just a little as this ancient toothed creature sort of swims along the underside of your ship. And does no damage this time around. ID Tenti, it is your turn. You were just about to buckle into the console of the ship.
I will quickly do a inventory check. Do we have any spears, harpoons? Are the ballistas functional?
Ooh, yeah. Did the ballistas make it? That's super important.
Ballistas. There is one working harpoon gun. Okay. The ship's major weapon does not fire. You guys had the weapons on you, so I know for a Vec, Zothak has a javelin. As he pronounced it last game, that he got back.
Question. Yeah. Do we have any empty barrels?
You guys just picked up a water barrel, and there's maybe one or two barrels beneath the ship. There's food stores in them that you guys were bringing.
I'm going to go ahead and
I'm just doing this manually.
I'm going to go ahead and gather ammo for the ballista if I can.
Prepping it. Okay, so you're going to run up to the front and load that up.
Yep.
Yep. Okay, cool. Let's put the shark back here. Oh, no, too far. All right, so ID10T heads up to the front, grabs a spear with a... I imagine there's like a cable attached to it. Yeah, it's a harpoon gun. Cool. So you get the harpoon gun all locked and loaded.
Is that my action?
What did you have something else in mind?
Well, I was thinking about that barrel.
What about that barrel? Tell me about that barrel, boy.
Well, kind of want to tie it to the spear.
If you want to spend your round doing that, we can say that's what you're doing.
All right, but I want to make a point that it is not going to be so quick that I will be able to do something with it. It's more of a time waster until Bado and Zothak start doing something.
How magnanimous of you!
Yes. All right, so you guys see ID10T rip out from inside of the interior of the ship, run up, and start messing with the harpoon equipment, tying the just-found barrel to the rope that the harpoon is connected to. Bado, what is up?
It's a tough call, but I'm going to try blindness, deafness.
That's good.
All right, roll it for me.
My God, can give and it can also take away. It needs to make a constitution save against 13, which is pretty low.
All right. This camera's on an angle, so whatever's rolling up doesn't look right. Con saving throw, that right there, gang.
Ugh. 16.
Do you guys like when I show you the rolls?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think it's fun. Okay, then I'll do it more. Ooh, what did I have to beat?
13.
Oh yeah, I beat it.
Yep.
So what were you trying to cast on it?
Blindness.
The shark gods laugh at your god. Oh man, I like to imagine the shark pulls out some real rad sunglasses. It's a radical shark. Yeah, so your spell does not quite hit the shark. The beam's coming down from the heavens, and it catches the waves, and it just like bounces into your eye, and you just miss the shot. Or damn, however you want to say you missed it. You've got a move action or a bonus action.
Let's see here. I'm above where I was looking at the barrel. I would try to get to a higher point in the ship so I can see it.
Highest point in the ship would be in the rear. Up where ID-10T was.
Yeah, so, I'll go up there.
All right, and so now you've got sort of a clearer view of the whole thing.
Gonna see if I can sacred fire it to death.
Well, you just cast blindness.
Yeah, no, it won't be this turn.
Okay, cool. Yeah, so now that you're up, you've got a better vantage on the shark circling you, making it Zothok's turn. Zothok, you see the Warforged tying a barrel to the harpoon. You saw your elephant friend try to cast a spell. It did not take, and so he ran up to the back of the ship to get a better vantage point.
Where is the sentient brain like thing?
It's sort of sniffing around at the ropes where ID-10T is tying the barrel.
In my turn, I should be able to look at ID-10T and look at Bado, right?
Yeah, you got it's 6 seconds. Yeah.
So they would technically have time to give me a nod or a yes. shake of the head.
Right? Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to pick up the little
guy. I'd have much more of like, you know, a little like,
I am not paying attention.
I would try to get your attention.
You hear, ID-10T, you hear in your head the voice of Kat saying, host, our friend's picking me up. Do you need me to do something?
I'll stop what I'm doing, look up, turn silently, just look over at Zothok and go, what's the plan, chief?
I have him in a backswing, if you will.
All right. I'm gonna let this play out.
All right. If he dies, he dies.
I'm a little curious what's going to happen here.
I don't know if I should.
You could ask just what make... it could do for us. Yeah.
Oh, listen to the music. You see the fin, that big 6-foot fin, peek out of the water.
Make the choice. Right,
here's the other thing I was thinking.
Uh-huh.
How big is its mouth? And if
it does do not I, have a mouth, it is a brain with feet.
No, sorry, the shark's mouth.
Oh, men have been talking about how big that shark's mouth is for generations. I seen him once.
Would I have seen what it looked like when it attacked? And can I roll to see if I thought it was possible for me to jump inside of it?
Inside of the mouth?
That's correct.
Yeah, you judging from the size of it, you probably.
Okay.
Wait. Okay.
Yeah, let's bring up the. Oh no,
I'm not sure. I stare at you and I cannot understand what you were thinking.
This is what Kat looks like, everybody. Kat, the intellect devourer. Our warforged wizard kept it in a pickled jar, and then after a blast of psychic energy while sailing the astral seas, it gained sentience.
Okay, well, how about this?
FYI. I will... For the wiki.
I had Anna backswing, and I had second thoughts. And uh-huh. So, rather than throwing him, I ask it, because I can see, it can probably see the shark now, because I'm holding it up, if it can help. And, yeah, so I'll wait for its response.
It does not commune with you. Right. ID10 to you hear it say, oh, there's a brain out there.
So I notice it's like Zothok's trying to command it, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to go, cat, mind your elders.
It looks excited, like a puppy that knows it's about to go for a car ride.
Yeah. So I'm going to basically just kind of tell it, like, do what he says.
All right, Zothok, what's up?
Fuck. This isn't what I thought it was going to be, so...
Continue wrapping that.
With what ID10 just said,
mm-hmm.
I do believe I'm going to throw it into the water while yelling attack. Yeah, I did that.
That's a thing that's happening.
All right, so you toss the intellect devourer into the water. We'll just say it's...
Uh-huh.
So cat goes, meow. But in like a cranial way. Let's make it size appropriate so you really get the scale.
Meow.
You fool. We should have tied a rope to it.
Not that rope. So you throw... cat the intellect devourer out into the water, and it sort of hits with a splash in the area of the shark. So the shark, you see it start to, it's swimming trying to keep its head up, and you see it sort of shimmy.
No.
Hold on. Sorry. I got to read it. I'm sorry, everybody. Give me a second.
Oh, boy. This is like, could you imagine just that 2 or 3 seconds that thing hits the water and we don't know what's going to happen?
So it hits. It hits the water, and you see it, like, it shimmies, and you see the shark's eyes sort of pulse with, like, a purple sheen, mm-hmm. And something happens. It looks affected, making it the shark's turn.
Oh, no. I shouldn't have thrown it in.
Oh, yeah, let me do it over here.
No use crying over spilt milk.
All right.
But I will watch this with extreme curiosity. What happens as my arms are twiddling with the rope around the barrel?
All right.
Oh boy.
So the shark opens its mouth.
And immediately kills it.
No, so it takes a chomp out of cat, but does not kill cat. But cat does look wounded.
No!
And you see the shark start to sort of frenzy as cat's brain blood spills into the briny depths of the ocean around you, making it ID10D's turn. Your pet. intellect devourer just got bit by a shark, what would you like to do?
I would like to finish up with that rope on the barrel, turn that bad boy over to the shark, and fire that harpoon right into it.
Alrighty. For that harpoon, roll me your d20 plus 8.
Oof. 12.
You fire. The bolt whips from the front of your ballista. You hear the spiraling of the rope as it uncoils, and it just misses the fin. Seriously, like, if you had let it just by an inch, you would have tagged it, but you just missed it.
And then I will hop off and say, I'm bad at this. Someone else take a shot.
And then a barrel shoots over the side that was tied to the harpoon.
Oh, we're going to need another barrel.
I said I used my rope for that.
he had another rope. Yeah, would you like a move at all?
I'll move aside to let somebody else take over.
All right.
And begin look around as I'm waiting for some, you know, another barrel.
Gotcha. Bado.
If we have one.
You are up.
I'm going to try to sacred flame the shit out of it.
All right.
Needs to make a 13 dex save.
Ooh, that's a 19.
Why do I bother?
Is there anything on a success?
You mean, is there anything on... Oh, on a...
Yeah, is it do half
yeah,
damage?
Yeah, it's success. No.
I mean, I meant on a fail, sorry. Alright, so you call down... Your god is just not answering any calls today, it seems, Bado.
Yeah.
Any bonus actions?
It's because I healed. Yeah, it was just. I used it on seasickness. I used my godly powers on seasickness.
Oh,
that was,
God's mad at you for
not,
like, your.
It's not becoming.
His service is in the corner store now. Alrighty. If there's nothing else,
I have an idea.
Then it'll be Zothok.
We didn't discuss this, but. Mm-hmm. I may have my bag of holding on me or near me, right?
Yeah, you've got it on you.
Okay. I would like to... is puking a bonus action, do you think, or is that a main action?
What do you... You want to make yourself nauseous again?
Yeah, I would like to try to stick my fingers down my throat and puke. Would that be... like a move? Like a... If I went to the edge of the ship to do that.
If it's a thing you really want to do, people can do that, right? I've never been able to do it, but people can do that.
Yeah, you make yourself puke. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. You. There's not much in your stomach. Just that coconut water. But if you, if you're feeling.
Would it leave me another action? For like that, I could wait for the shark.
Sure. Are you trying to bait the shark?
That's correct.
Sure, you could do that.
Okay, I'm gonna do something real dumb.
Alright.
So Thakwood, he goes over the edge of the thing, sticks his fingers in his mouth, pukes down along the side and into the water, and I will wait until the shark comes and opens his mouth, and then I will to attack. And then I will take the rest of my turn.
Yeah,
I like cool. Have the Jaws theme playing as you're saying this.
Yes.
Sounds so much epic.
All right. Here, let's get this a little rearranged. So Zothok causes himself to vomit as a way to chum the water. Put the brain out there.
This very well could kill me, and this is great.
All right, so it is the shark's turn. Let's see. I'm going to do a perception check, see if I smell the vomit. I rolled a 1 as a shark, so think I'm more interested in this brain thing. Yeah. There's blood in the water, so I have advantage. That's another one. This is a 10. So enough to hit.
Oh no. Oh, the poor little guy.
And you see Cat just sort of disappear beneath the surface.
Oh no.
You'll be fine.
The music. All right, ID10T.
Is anyone else taking it look like they're going to take a shot with the harpoon?
No, I don't think so.
I really want to do something really stupid.
Uh-huh. I mean, the orc just puked.
Yeah. I'm not. We threw Cat overboard.
Nothing but wrong ideas here, bud.
Question. Question.
Yeah.
This is not going well today.
It's all right. Am I buoyant?
So as you recall, you came to sentience when Zothok was propelled future through time into the present, his future. And you have no recollection of your life before this. You do not recall being around in water, so you're not sure.
All right.
But you're also a wizard with a bevy of spells and a chamber inside of you that might be buoyant.
I'm going to go ahead and bet on it.
Yeah.
Is there rope around me?
Sure, there's one more roll of rope that was not used to tie up the barrel.
Tie the rope around me.
All right.
And then tie it to the next spear bolt for the ballista.
Okay. You're tying yourself off to the deck?
No, I'm tying it to the projectile.
Oh. I see. Okay.
What?
Don't worry.
Oh, because he's a giant barrel.
How much actions is that going to take, though? I imagine that'll take my turn.
Yeah, tying the rope to you in a secure way. So you guys see ID10T roll up and rig himself to the next harpoon bolt.
What are you doing?
Don't worry. I've thought this through.
If he dies, he dies.
Wait. He has been in the water. He was underneath in the sewer thing underneath the city.
Yeah, but that wasn't like deep water. That was all like ankle water.
Plus I was holding on to the thing.
Yeah.
Okay. And you're thinking that, so I don't hear it.
Yeah.
I say it.
What?
I guess that makes it Bado's turn.
Yeah. I'll be back real quick.
Yeah.
All right. Having sensing that I'm getting the cold shoulder from my holy patron, I pull out the trusty old light crossbow.
Alrighty. I love it. You gonna fire off at that shark?
Yup.
Roll me that ranged attack.
8. I feel good about this.
You rolled an 8, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Man, we're gonna get you some new dice. 8 does not hit the shark. You fire the bolt, and you see it sort of ricochet and deflect when it hits the water surface.
Mm-hmm.
You have a bonus action or anything of the such? Anything else you could do?
Nope.
No?
I'm back.
Alrighty. So, Bado drew a crossbow, fired the bolt off at the shark circling the arc, and did not make the hit. Zothok Your plan does not seem to have worked, at least yet, because you noticed the intellect devourer get pulled under. So, what would you like to do?
There's more of those thingies at the back, right?
Yeah.
I can make it to that, right? I guess I'll try to fire one of those off at the old Sharkaroonie.
You don't want to fire the one that ID Tenti's tied to?
I'm sorry. Yes, absolutely.
He tied himself to a bolt of one.
Okay, yes. Yeah, let's fire him. Everything else went wrong. Why not this?
Alrighty, so roll me a...
I'm just watching you run past me and, like, my little eye stalk turns and it's like, ha ha ha.
Bado wasn't willing to do it, and Zothok saw what was going on.
Okay.
So Bado, like, pulled a crossbow and fired,
right,
and Zothok.
It's his crossbow. Okay, yeah. Sorry.
So Zothok runs up to the harpoon. Roll me a d20 and add 8.
20.
You rolled a 20?
No, a 12 plus 8, so 20.
20 hits.
I can hear the rope.
Roll me 2d10.
Oh, man. Sorry. Just...
Ooh. This might be a bad idea.
Twelve.
So the bolt fires out zzz, and sticks into the side of the shark and does some damage. And now the shark is technically grappled by ID Tenti, who is then pulled into the water.
Is he buoyant? Or
he is.
Does it float?
He is buoyant.
Okay. Wasn't sure if we're new yet.
Yeah, he can technically swim unless the character says otherwise. I see
you pulling me, and you know how when you pull something through the water at speed, like that big kind of
wake?
Like wait, yeah, the thing, the big hill of water is going over it, and I'm just kinda like
Alright, so we're gonna say It's mostly grappled. This is an IBS original. So grappled means the creature speed becomes zero. So ID Tenti flies off like Mac and me again off the side of the boat, hits the water. He sort of like dunks in. The water claps over him, and then he pops back up and sort of does that buoyancy. And he's like, hey, I'm buoyant. And then the rope gets tight as the shark starts to pull and fight, and you feel yourself jerking in the water, confident it's not going to go anywhere, and then the shark gets its full strength and slowly starts to drag you with him around the ship. It is the shark's turn.
You hear that bell? That's me.
It is going to
be the buoy.
It is slowed, so it's going to turn its might. I'm trying to use my hand like an idiot. And chomp at the side of your ship. And it's going to hit the side of your ship.
I knew I should have waited.
Your ship rocks as you hear some more wood you hear a plank sort of pull and pop as it's pried off, but not enough force to rip the board completely off, and you start to hear little spills of water underneath the ship. making it ID10T's turn. You are. Now that you've jumped the shark, thanks.
Nice.
You are slowly being towed in the water by this giant shark. I imagine.
His eyes talk above the water.
What would you like to do, bud?
How far away am I from the shark itself?
I imagine it's a 50-foot rope. You used maybe 10, 12 feet to wrap around you. I don't know, maybe you're 15 feet behind it?
I am going to... Man, that's a good question. Now what?
Do you have any fun items on you haven't used? Any spells or?
I have one, but it requires some very tricky maneuvering.
So you can also hold your action if you would like to. Also, if you're like, I would like Bado and Zothok to go before me, you can absolutely do that. Anytime you guys are in a chunk next to each other and you want to change your order, as long as it's before another NPC, you're free to do it. Just let me know. What's your question?
So I have a. Can I ask you out of the channel real quick?
I'm streaming right now. Can you send me a message?
Yes, I can.
Yeah. Bado and Zothok, you guys think about what you're going to be doing while I wait for this message.
Gonna try. Zothok, are you going to use the Ballista?
I mean, I'm just kind of there right now, so do what you need to do, and then I'll play around that.
All right, let's see this message. Oh. Oh, that's a real interesting question. Ooh, hold up. I don't want to leave you guys hanging, but keep talking amongst yourselves. It's
But now you've piqued our curiosity.
I'm currently doing research because I have a thing I'm going to try, but...
Ooh.
Hold on one second.
I will probably wait to see what you're going to try.
I try not to let myself let the actual books get too involved, but this is one of those times where it's like, oh, I need a little clarification because it's...
To the books!
Yeah.
I have some idea.
Yeah? Can't stop, won't stop moving. That Nine
yes,
Inch Nails?
Huh? What about the... I have a feeling, okay, that makes sense. So that's gonna be a no-go.
All right.
But... Good. I'm going to go ahead and start pulling myself closer to it and fixing the rope to me so then I don't, if I release the rope, I don't like fall back to my current position. Does that make sense?
No, say that again. I'm sorry.
So like, I'm going to like be pulling the rope so that I get closer and closer to it.
Uh-huh. Oh, but if you need to let go, you'll be at a distance.
Well, if I need to let go, it's like tied to me. So I'm not going to, fall back to like 15 or 20 feet.
Gotcha. Did you see what I wrote to you just now? Oh. Yeah, we could do that.
You really want to do that?
Yeah, I think that's. Yeah.
All right.
But you have to, like, start doing...
If that is the case, then I have to wait.
You're going to hold... Sorry, guys.
No, we're good. I'm...
The music's really making it more intense for me. I'm seeing the dots as he's writing, and I'm like, what is this?
Oh, I started playing it on my side because I wasn't hearing it.
So, oh, you don't hear it?
I hear it.
Okay, I got it now.
So do you want to hold your turn then, bud?
Yes, I will hold my turn for now.
Okay. All right, Bado.
Continue to.
If I see that Zothok... No, I'll shout out, like, Zothok, are you doing the ballista? Can I have a go?
I shake my head.
Sweet. I'll move over to the ballista. Does it need an action to load?
We'll give it to you. Zothok had it loaded for you.
Oh, that's nice of him.
The intensity of combat has made him forget about his seasickness, and so he's got nervous, idle hands. So, yeah. Yeah, so you can move up to the crossbow for sure. Sorry,
I'm debating whether I want to bless instead. This may be the last chance everybody's in range. Just a d4, though. I haven't done very... Yeah, I'll go ahead and cast Bless. So everybody, or Zothok and Identity... You are both within range, so you'll both be able to add a d4 to attack and saving throws for the next, for the foreseeable future here.
Zothok, Bado's God finally answered the call.
But just for a little bit of help, just for a nice just little, you know, like,
little deuces machina.
I don't know if this will work.
Only one way to find out.
What happens when you invert a bag of holding? Does the other plane dump out into our?
No, I think the contents empty out.
That's what I mean. Yeah.
But the other universe wouldn't. I think it would. At some point, like, start occurring on the what wood is now the inside of the bag of holding. Or, let's say, you're trying to reach your thumbs to you can't do it. You like, push from the outside, but the inside is never able to make it all the way up to the top.
Mm.
So you can't completely...
Yeah, you can't, yeah. It's a paradox. It won't. What did you have in mind?
Jumping all of the air out from inside of it.
Oh, for what purpose?
Exploding a shark from the inside.
Oh.
It would be roughly 108 cubic feet of air that you could. Near instantly expand.
No, but you feel like maybe there would be a way to achieve that same idea without reversing the bag of holding.
Then I will wait my turn for that shark to come at the ship again and attack.
Okay.
I'm gonna try it.
Okay.
I thought about doing that too with Creator Destroy Water. Destroy water, 10 gallons of water underneath the shark, and it collapses immediately.
Yeah. Yeah, you could do that.
So yeah, that's what I said about like.
All right.
You didn't do anything on this turn, right, Zothok? I'm sorry, Bado. You didn't really do anything, right?
I cast Bless.
Oh, you cast Bless.
I figured this might be the last time we're all in range.
You cast Bless as a bonus action.
All right. Then I try to collapse 10 gallons of water directly
so,
underneath.
Tell me the spell you're doing again. Like, describe this to me.
So because we were going through and talking about provisions, mm-hmm. I made sure to prepare... Create or destroy water.
Okay.
And that's one spell.
So you are going to tell me what you're going to do.
I'm going to cast destroy water on a area of water just underneath the shark.
So that water ceases to exist.
Right.
And the shark drops.
Well, it'd be 10 gallons, so only...
Yeah, it's not a whole heck of a lot.
Would try to fill that area.
Really, the thing is, the water rushes in to replace it. And
he would try to replace it as well, part of his body. The question is, how fast does the water disappear? Is it instant?
I think it's instant.
It says instantaneous.
If it's instantaneous, then there's so much PSI in that. Like,
boom shakalaka.
All right.
I don't even know how you would roll damage.
Okay, wait. And so, hold on. I'm getting everybody's ideas together. So Bado has a spell to create and destroy water, like 10 gallons of water. Zothok wants to use the bag of holding to force more mass into the shark at some point. And then ID10T has that idea.
That I did the slowing down idea. I can't wait for him to be dragged across the bottom as the shark.
I think that we're referring to the idea that will not be named.
Yeah.
That we don't know because we're not awesome.
Yeah.
I just wanted to surprise y'all.
I'm excited.
So you want, James, you wanted to wait until the shark was in their view, right? And they're all holding their actions for when the shark's in their view.
All right.
Oops. Dang it. That's what you get for streaming for on an app that's not meant for streaming. Oh, no. I turned it the wrong way. All right. So the shark slowly drifts around the back. Did it again of the ship and starts to come around on the starboard side. There we go. With ID10T in tow, he slowly pulled himself up.
Hey guys.
So these guys, you see them as you come around. The camera's now in the water, right? It's a handheld camera being drugged by this shark prop. As you're coming around the back side of the ship, and you see Zothok and Bado looking over the edge, waiting for this approach.
Okay, as it approaches,
We'll
go ahead and cast it.
All right.
And so,
describe how it looks.
So, you see my body kind of little pores. Through the cracks in the wood, you see gray mist start to seep out, and it envelops me. And then all of a sudden, it goes poof, and the rope flies towards the ship, and then I poof, on deck, and I'm dripping wet on deck. And I'm like, hello! And then I immediately... run around the mast a couple times to secure the rope.
So, ID10T Misty stepped onto the ship with the rope still connected to the shark.
Right.
That's what we were talking about.
And he wrapped it around the mast.
And yeah.
And I wrapped it around the mast.
So, ID10T mists up onto the deck and starts doing that, making it Bado's turn. You both now see the shark. The rope that it's attached to pulls tight, and the shark pulls to the left, sort of in pain and sort of biting, and you get a clear shot of like three rows of sharp, jagged mandibles going back into this opening and collapsing maw. Salt water and remnants of brain devourer are stuck in its jaws. Hey, there we go again.
I forgot about that.
Now I'm sad.
I thought I was hoping he was alive. He got swallowed whole.
We can rebuild him.
You know, Pinocchio.
So the shark has turned and its mouth open facing you.
So do, are they separate mandibles or are like just rows of teeth?
Rows of teeth.
Do you think I could jump in? Do I think I could jump in?
Yeah, you could jump in.
I'm gonna jump in. Let's jump
What is your intent after you jump into the mouth of the giant shark?
I'm going to. As soon as like is I want to get as deep as I can,
mm-hmm.
and then try to open the bag and release all of that air as quick as I can.
Okay. Bado.
CO2 bottle inside of a balloon.
Bado, what were you? What was your plan?
Destroy 10 gallons of water underneath the shark.
Okay. Trying to think how this all plays out. ID10 team Misty steps onto the ship, the rope attached, and starts making his rounds, pulling tight the cord attached to the shark. It winces in pain, turning its head towards the ship. Zothok sees his opening, clutching the bag of holding, and jumps into the mouth of the shark.
Smile, you son of a bitch.
I'm smiling. Oh. Looks like meat's back on the menu, boys. Thank you, Kraken. All right, so you jump into there, and so you're trying to, like, accordion squeeze the contents of a bag of holding out?
When I'm inside of it, I want to, as fast as I can, release whatever it's 60 or 80 cubic feet of air.
What all was in the bag of holding? Do you remember?
I don't know if there was anything else in there.
You didn't puke in there, did you?
I'd use it to breathe. I don't have any notes on it, but I had used it to breathe a couple of times.
Okay.
Just a fun bag for parties.
All right.
It's my breathing bag so far.
When you go to one of those places with the all-you-can-eat shrimp buffet, you know, just...
See, it's weird. So, like, the bag of holding is described as having 64 cubic feet.
Mm-hmm.
But 15 minutes of air.
Mm-hmm.
And you use about 80 cubic feet of air a minute.
How much force? What, like, what? Give me an equivalent force of the air coming out of this bag of holding. Come on, engineers.
Well, first, you take the maximum, the how fast you could push the back end back, and just assume that that's proportional to your 64 cubic feet. And I actually don't know what I'm doing.
If it's if you're going from one cubic foot. No, I mean, it's like an instantaneous injection of 64 cubic feet.
All right, here we go. Here's what we're going to do.
How would you calculate that expansion rate?
I'm going to do this. Okay. You jump into the mouth. The jaws shut behind you. Bado... taps into the extraplanar magic and swipes water out from under the shark. The shark pops down. Water kind of collapses in from all sides. As Zothok is trying to like squeeze his bag of holding, he's given extra help from the jaws popping down. As the shark dropped, hit water, and then more water collapsed onto it, pushing forward this air and semi-inflating this shark. The air pushes through. You hear the tearing of cartilage, and then it sort of accordions back and spits Zothok out of the mouth. But blood and entrails and a couple of teeth from the mass pressure from both sides, right? The water pressure from outside and air pressure from in.
No cat, right? Cat didn't get spit out with.
There's a leg floating next to you. If cat was here right now, he'd be trying to eat my brains.
I'm sorry, cat.
But you notice the burst of pressure, like where the gills are, part of them ripped, right? That was the least resistant meat in this animal, and a chunk of it is hanging off, and it does not look in a good place, and it is still tied to the mast of the ship, making it the shark's turn.
No.
The shark, upset, frenzied at the blood in the water, sees Zothok swimming in front and is going to bite at him. I did.
I rolled a 4 and a 9.
But sharks have a big ass hit. Zothok's armor is a 17. All right. So the shark bites you for 14 points of damage.
Okie dokie. Been taken.
Yeah, so this shark comes out and it wraps its teeth around your torso and just kind of bites down like so much Twinkie.
Don't spew out.
Bado.
That doesn't look good.
Or Zothok or ID10T. You guys all are on the same initiative, so if somebody would like to go before somebody else.
I'll try shooting it again. No, I'll actually use the harpoon this time.
All right, D20 plus 8.
D20 plus 8.
And
them's good odds. 23
is a hit. Roll me 2D10, please. Nice. You fire your harpoon. You've kind of turned back 45 degrees, and you hit it just below the left eye. And it shakes. You swear you see the seam in the rubber. Zothok or ID10T?
Did he release me, or am I still in his mouth?
You weren't technically in his mouth. It was just
I didn't know if I was like within stabbing.
You were within. Yeah, you were next to it.
Okay. Well, I'm going to. I do believe I can. Oh shit! I should have done it at the beginning because I always forget about this. But that's fine.
Frenzied.
Yeah.
The barbarian gets pissed at being bit by a shark.
Yeah.
So you're gonna enter your barbarian rage?
Trying to read it. So it's tech. Is it frenzy? While raging, you can choose to frenzy. Okay. So that's my action, right?
So, on your turn as a bonus action, so not your move, not your attack, as your bonus action, you enter a fit of rage. You have advantage on strength attacks, like melee.
Saving throws.
Yeah, saving throws. You have resistance to bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing. So, the shark's teeth pierce your skin, so while you are raging, you take half the damage from the shark's bite.
Cool. My bonus raged, right?
So I think you get an extra attack because of your frenzy, right?
Yeah, well, it says you can choose to frenzy while raging. Which then gives you an extra attack with my melee weapon.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so let's attack this guy with the two, my two daggers. So it'll be two different attacks, right? Which uses a...
Uses a d20. Two attacks, d20s.
All right, I'm going to reroll. I rolled a six. I'm going to use my inspiration to reroll that one. 20 for that one.
Nice.
Turn off my inspiration. So get that. That's a d4, which is somewhere around here. Got it. So 3 plus 3, so 6 for that one.
So one of your daggers plunges into the shark.
Is... Oh, it's plus 2 on the melee damage, right?
Yeah. Your strength bonus.
So that's 8 on that one. And then I'll roll the second dagger. Oof. 9 probably does not hit.
9 does not hit.
Yeah. So, what'd I say? 8 damage?
Okay. Yeah, you plunge your dagger into it. ID10T. The shark is looking pretty worse for wear.
I almost want to go again. I guess I'll go ahead. I'll do a little bit of the traditional.
Mm-hmm.
The old. I'll batter up and open up my hatch. You hear a charging noise.
Mm-hmm.
And you hear something like a circuit connecting, and a small ball of lightning flies out from my little port.
All right.
Straight at the shark.
Is it ranged touch attack, or do I need to make a check?
Just let me check right now. So, one action, 90 feet, instantaneous. I make a ranged spell attack.
All right.
So, roll that real quick.
Roll that beautiful bean footage.
Oh, okay. That's going to be a 9.
A 9 does not hit.
Okay.
Does anything happen on a miss?
No, I don't think so.
All right, so you fire this bolt off. The ship is rocked by a wave, and your horizon line's throwing off, and your bolt sort of shoots off into the distance.
I like to imagine it kills the flock of birds that have been flying.
Shark's turn. Shark is not, it's slowing down. It doesn't look like it's being hostile towards you, Zothok.
Okay.
It's sort of whinging in pain.
That's what it gets. Kill cat. I didn't kill cat. It killed cat.
So it, let's see. Ooh, I guess. How do I do this? ID10T, you are sort of the placeholder for the ship. So will you roll me a d20?
All right. 19.
All right. So the shark. Dives beneath the surface, and it can't get too far because the rope is still attached to the mast, and it pulls the ship a little. The ship starts to drift. It's making a strength attack against the ship, trying to get away beneath the surface, and it's just slowly dragging the ship to the right. Bado, or anybody really, it's your team's turn.
Is it underwater?
Yeah, it dove.
Is Zothok still in the water?
Zothok is still in the water, but it does not seem interested in Zothok.
I want to get Zothok out of the water. Attempt rescue operations.
Alrighty.
Throw him a rope. Rope.
Okay.
Bado is going to initiate to assist Zothok in getting out of the water.
Yeah.
Zothok?
Yeah, I'd like to get out of the water. It'd be dope.
All right, so you guys...
Not that you want.
Spend your turn getting Zothok out of the water. ID10T.
Get up on deck and get on that steering wheel.
The ship is still drifting right as the shark continues to pull.
I'm gonna turn that ship on, lock into that socket, and start revving it in the other direction.
So you're gonna try to pull the shark?
Yeah.
All right.
If I had a mouth, I would smile at Bado and Zothok like this was a great idea.
So the ship powers up again, drawing energy from your system. So it's powered up just enough to move. The shark underneath is trying to pull, and it's an even match. Neither one of you seem to be making any room against the other.
Okay. I'm going to let them think of something, and I'm just going to keep it going.
It's like in Rocket League when you're stuck in a headlock with somebody. Bado Zothok.
Let's fire. We got another bolt to fire, right?
Yeah.
Let's fire that bolt.
Can we see it if it's down deep down?
It is resurfacing again during its tussle with ID10T. So yeah, you can fire it. D20 plus 8.
And I also want to make sure the other end's tied to the ship.
Okay.
10.
What are you firing with, Zothok?
The big thingy.
Bado was manning that one.
Oh, I thought he... Oh, sorry. He helped me out, so I'm not sure he's there yet. Can I make it to one? I mean, whichever the back.
Yeah, D20.
I rolled
plus 8.
I rolled a 10, so I don't think I.
Including that includes the 8.
That's correct.
All right.
23 to hit.
23 hits. Roll me those 2d10s.
I thought there was only one. 7 points of damage. Lame.
And so
I thought there was only one ballista.
You got another one working in the course of the combat. There were 3 total, and one wasn't functional, but Zothok was able to. It didn't work. He tried to fire it, and it missed. It wasn't functional. You're right. Zothok forgot. Quick. So did I.
As Zothok is climbing the stairs, I'm going to roll to high-five him.
He only has to roll if he doesn't want to high-five you back.
Yeah, I rolled a 6.
Zothok, do you want to high-five the Warforged?
I rolled a 10. I miss.
Was it too slow? All right. You rolled 7 damage, Bado.
Yes.
So Bado fires the harpoon gun into the shark, and that seems to be the killing blow. It hits, and the shark tenses up for a second, and then relaxes and starts to drift a little bit.
Hooray!
You have defeated the giant shark of Shark Week.
We have murdered it.
A weapon.
All we had to do was sacrifice our beloved pet.
We didn't sacrifice anything. He jumped out of my arms into the water.
Technically, it was the shark that killed him.
It's okay. He had a good life. When we murdered him in the city and pickled him.
Well, that was after you guys brained his first owners. Just kidding.
I feel like I probably shouldn't have done that.
But... Oh, we murdered his owners, yes.
So, we can turn the Jaws music off.
And I'm gonna pat if Sothok, are you feeling guilty as a character?
That's a great question. I mean, it's
I
not...
feel guilt as a bonus action.
Yeah, it's not necessarily a it's nothing illegal or unlawful.
I'm going to pat you on the back and say, just think of it as a learning experience. We can always get more cats. They're plentiful.
Still feel bad.
You feel bad about cat?
Maybe if eat leg, not feel so bad.
I wouldn't.
You want to eat the leg of the intellect devourer?
It was, because, he's a hunter. He wouldn't want to waste.
Well. I'm going to disconnect, roll over, and start pulling the shark closer. Is it buoyant? Or is it dragging down?
Yeah, it's buoyant.
Yeah, I'm going to pull it over to us. Start pulling.
Yeah,
as best I can, because it's
pretty large. I'll help while asking, what do you want to do with it? Pulling slower
like
now.
To, let's get it on deck first.
Bato, do you want to talk in the other chat? No. You want to pull the shark aboard?
If we can.
It's huge. Can we do that?
Yeah, of course you can.
I mean, it doesn't look as big as the boat. But that might
and
be.
That's still. It's 1,000 pounds easy.
We're strong.
A gigantic, strong Luxodon, a gigantic half-orc caveman, and a freakishly, undeterminable strength of my robotic arms, noodle arms. I'm sure we could manage to get it up on deck.
It's got a little, it's got a gradient on it. Sorry, that's for the water. Let's see?
Yeah, no, it's fine.
It's not a ghost shark.
I swear I that's caught good. A fish this big.
Ah, now I get it.
You're able to pull the shark on board. And
it might make a trophy. We could earn money for it, maybe.
Well, once it's on board, I'm going to go, now that that's out of the way, what about the wreckage?
We should be able to comb the wreckage without an interruption this time.
Absolutely, yeah. You guys comb through the wreckage, and you find a crate of goods. I will roll it for you guys, but not now.
Okay.
Because I don't want to hold the stream up. So we'll start the next adventure with you guys opening a crate up, maybe. But you are able to get the ship going again whenever you feel ready to. We can discuss what happens to the shark next time.
Sounds good.
But you guys... continue the rest of your trek, the 4-day sail to the mainland. And we'll say it's just before sunup as you start to see the peaks and crags of land in the distance and the plume of smoke off in the distance from one of them as you approach the mainlands just before sunrise. And that's where we'll call today's adventure.
Yay!
Yeah.
I killed things.
We've now murdered aquatic life.
Yeah,
all right.
Everything in our path dies.
I will give myself, we rested, so I will give myself back.
Everybody has hit level 4.
Yay!
We will talk about the shark stuff, and we'll talk about your level 4 benefits off the air. If there's anything else, do you guys have anything before we sign off?
Nope.
No.
Stay safe, wear a mask.
Cool beans. Well, thank you guys. Thanks everybody for stopping in and watching us. We play the Axe Narcana D&D fantasy adventure game every Wednesday at 7 p.m. Central. Join us next week for the accompanying adventure with a different party. Join us Thursdays at 8 for the Volcano Gaming Club. We play Rocket League and Overwatch and Red Dead Redemption. Ooh, Red Dead Redemption, the Butterscotch Boys. Come check us out sometime. Follow me on Twitter. When I go live on Twitch, a tweet gets sent out. So that's the best way to see when we're live. Listen to 103.1 SPKY, the spookiest podcast around. And I might be on later for some video games. I don't know. But we will call that the Axe Narcana for today. So we'll see you guys next time. Bye.
Bye.
Gonna fall, a reservoir dogs. Have you run like babies on the crawl? Or have you tied up with the quick?